During a recent research rabbit hole, I came across a truly bewildering place that abodes perhaps the strangest geology in the American West. After digging a bit deeper, I learned just how isolated this innate structure is, and that if I wanted to see it, I would need to venture deep into the remote desert. But if there's one thing that I have realized about exploration, it's that the more difficult journeys often come with a much sweeter reward. So I packed a bag and hit the road. What's up, everybody? Johnny Out West here. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we are headed to a canyon that is home to perhaps some of the most interesting geological structures and landscapes I've ever seen. Of course, I haven't actually seen them yet with my own eyes, but I've seen pictures. So this place is not talked about very often, and it took a little bit of digging for me to find this. Oh, I just saw a little groundhog. Cool. I have about 30 minutes left in my drive, but excited to get there and see something new and unique. Stay tuned. All right, so we have now gotten onto a dirt road that we're going to be going down for 3 miles. So this is interesting. These wild horses here? Yeah, I think this is just a wild horse right here. Oh, there's more. These guys are just roaming free. That's pretty crazy. Hey, buddy.
To be honest, I always feel a bit of apprehension when venturing into remote places by myself. But those nervous feelings pale in comparison to the excitement of a new adventure. Once I arrived at the canyon, I noticed another traveler, a solo pronghorn. As I watched this solitary creature gracefully survey the area, I began feeling this mystical energy. Whatever it was seemed to perfectly set the tone for the otherworldly environment I was about to uncover.
I'll tell you what, this place, you know, I'm just about to kind of walk over this ridge that seems to take you into the canyon, and it's already very interesting. These rock formations that I'm seeing here are just, they almost have like a melted look. It kind of looks like I'm about to walk into a boneyard. It's kind of like a creepy vibe. But as you can see, I am the only one here, and there's not another soul in sight. So here we go. Pretty crazy. I think there's a scene in The Lion King where Simba is down in some like boneyard, some like super dark scene, and this is kind of what it feels like. So yeah, I mean, what's interesting is that this canyon is very shallow. It's really not much of a canyon, but I guess we'll kind of see. Whoa. Oh my gosh. It almost looks like an above ground, like coral reef kind of thing. What? Huh. Yeah, I mean, this almost looks like just a bunch of toys that got like scattered on the ground here. Big rocks, small rocks. This thing is crazy. In terms of its shape, it really does look like, you know, gigantic coral. Looks like we got a little path going up here. Much more over here. Seems to be the outskirts. Show you what I just walked down. Oh, okay. Whoa. Oh my god.
There's more to be seen. Yeah, it was cool as I was, oh my gosh, wow. Look at this. This is crazy. It looks like toys that were just kind of left out on the ground. I think the best way I could describe these rock structures is that they look like they almost just melted. They're just so bizarre.
So, what could possibly explain how all of this came to be? What caused this type of weathering to occur that could craft such intricate shapes and perplexing structures? There is, of course, a history to this land that tells the story of how it got here, but I'm afraid it doesn't paint the whole picture, at least from my perspective. From about 35 to 55 million years ago, this canyon stood at the rim of Lake Uinta, a massive subtropical lake that engulfed the Uinta Basin in Utah and parts of western Colorado. Rivers that fed into the lake deposited organic material such as sand, silt, and clay that was shed from the nearby mountains. Once buried underground, the sediments eventually solidified into layers of sandstone, mudstone, and claystone. Over time, as the lake dried up and the underlying stone began to weather and erode, these shapes have formed due to the difference in the rate of erosion between the rock types. While the mudstone and claystone have been stripped away by wind and water, the slightly stronger sandstone has remained and been formed into the bizarre shapes we see today. Although this history of the land explains a lot, some of this landscape still remains a mystery to me, and I can't seem to understand why this location specifically has such a different anatomy than everything else that surrounds it.
All right, so let's kind of continue on our way here. Tell you what, I was sleeping in my car last night. And the sleeping pad that I just bought would not stay inflated. And so I didn't really have much that I was sleeping on. So my back and my neck are a little roughed up today, not feeling 100%. Okay. Went over here. Just got this kind of like badland geography. Oh. So crazy. Really want to start to learn more about geology and just kind of how all this came to be, since I've kind of taken an interest in digging a little deeper on these explorations and, you know, finding cool spots. You know, it's like I want to witness amazing things, but I also want to understand them a little bit better. Kind of just like a creepy vibe, you know, a lot of times when you're in the majestic canyons and, you know, Moab and Zion, and you know, it's very welcoming landscapes that are just beautiful and breathtaking. And this one, it's different. You know, I don't necessarily see it and then say, ooh, I want to go in there kind of thing. You know what I mean? I almost want to just like look from a distance because it's just creepy. It's just like, that's the best way I can honestly describe it. It's certainly a sight to see, that's for sure. I mean, it's just amazing this happened naturally, you know? Well, I'll tell you what. The sun has really fully come out for the first time today. And it feels great. It feels really nice to have some sunshine on my face. Just enjoying the peacefulness and serenity of being out here with not another soul in sight. All right. Seems like this is kind of like the biggest, most open part of the canyon. Wow. Oh my gosh. Oh my god. Like this stuff up here, it almost looks like little arms that these rocks have. It's so cool. And this right here, that looks like a dinosaur, like a bird's face. That's crazy. It's amazing. And then here you have these like big imprints. Lots to take in here. Right there, that's so cool. Yeah, I mean, you could stare at this stuff all day. You know, it's a small place. I'm glad I came here though. I'm glad I came to check it out for myself. I think it was worth it. But it's just, you know, it's like everywhere you look here, it's something different and cool. Check this one out. I will say if you've ever been diving, you know, and like done like coral reef diving, like it kind of feels like this, you know? Like this is kind of a bigger scale than what I've seen, but like it kind of feels like I'm underwater right now, just diving through a coral reef. Ooh. You know, even though this place is so small, you could still spend hours upon hours here looking at all the details, you know, if you really appreciate that kind of thing. But this has been one of my shorter excursions and probably shorter videos, but I hope you liked this one. I hope you enjoyed seeing this really unique and interesting place. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel, leave me some feedback, like the video, please, and more videos and adventures out west coming soon. This is Johnny Out West signing off. See you guys.